Hello, hello. This is
How are you?
how
How
are
is your day
you?
going?
Yeah, I guess it's really pointless to ask if you think about it because, like, who's
Oh,
gonna
obviously
ask?
you start off every episode just by asking how's your day going?
Yes, how's your day going or night, wherever you live? How are you doing, Raj? How are you doing?
All right.
Is
I
life
have to
good?
go for a walk in like an hour. I made like a promise to like my personal trainer because like we do like goals every single week. He's like,
Goals.
okay, well, yeah, he's like goals. So, like, what's your biggest win, and what are you gonna do for like this week, right? And we're in like a group chat together, so I have to like kind of like encourage each other. So my goal and like what I have to do is like walk 10,000 steps every single day.
Yeah.
Like go to the gyms, like come to the gym like before 12, so like in the morning. And I think there's one more. Oh yeah, re start reading a book.
Just any book.
Yeah, pretty much any book.
That's nice.
Because like I told him like I'm not like sleeping properly, right?
Yeah.
Like I just like sleep until I just go on my phone, and then I like sleep whenever I feel like sleepy, whenever I like can't open my eyes. And he said, oh, that's not a really good thing because like that fucks up with your like sleep schedule, and like because you see a lot of light, it like messes up, like like it just messes with your quality of sleep. So he said, like, you'd probably read a book before you go to bed. So that's why like I also have to like start reading.
Why
But
not?
like okay, so like the consequences, right? 'Cause
Yeah.
I like so today is Sunday, and right now I've taken 236 steps. It
Poggers.
is 4 o'clock. It's 4 o'clock, meaning at 5 I have to go out and like take 10,000 steps today. If I don't, I get a haircut.
Will get a haircut if you don't.
Yeah, I have to cut my hair short. Like I fucking hate having like short hair. Like I much rather prefer having long hair than short hair.
Bro, what is this? This is
You
short hair. Wait, why are you so
didn't say
scared of
short.
short hair?
Well, I'm not scared of short hair. I just don't like how short hair looks on me. I'm
Okay.
sure how long.
Damn.
Bro, that's crazy, bro.
It's crazy,
When did
bro.
I ask?
It's really cool, actually. Like, for your punishment, pretty pog if you
Yeah,
ask me. I don't know, I can
like
never like read a book before bed because whenever I read a book, I have to focus on it. But reading it before bed, it's like it doesn't. I can't sleep because my mind just goes to it.
no, like reading sometimes like just reading a book, since I really don't give a shit about reading. I just like I don't know, bro. Like I just like read until like my eyes can't like focus
Yeah.
on like the words. And that happened yesterday when I was like watching Evangelion,
Oh yeah, of course.
and I was like reading the subtitles, but then I couldn't like focus on it, and I kept like drifting off to sleep.
That happens, man.
Poggers.
Poggers. Evangelion.
Even.
Watch My Hero Academia.
Watch My Hero Academia,
Yes.
especially if you love minors.
Minus, yes.
Bro,
Bro, what is it with My Hero Academia, man? I don't understand.
like My Hero Academia fans, or just like My Hero Academia in
No, I
general?
watched My Hero Academia a little bit.
I don't know. I think it's a good show. Like,
It is. The art
it's a
style is
pretty.
really cool.
Yeah, like I really like the anime. It's just like people like the one thing people don't like universally is like just the fan base. And I can see why. Like the fan base just fucking sucks for My Hero Academia.
Any fan base I feel like is annoying. It doesn't
Oh
matter
yeah,
what it is. Any fucking
like
fan base.
I think the worst fan base, there really isn't like the worst fan base, but like there is definitely like fan bases that just like all fan bases just cringe, you know. And I think like the worst one, well, not really the worst one, but like one of the worst ones that I was like, I don't know, like I was like the Big Bang Theory fan base. It just fucking sucks.
I know. I haven't really engaged with a Big Bang Theory fan. I don't know how they live in the wild.
Well, they don't really fucking like, you know, they're not really like wild creatures. They just fucking suck. They're just extremely cringe.
They just don't have any benefit to the world.
They don't contribute to society.
I don't know. I feel like the worst type of fan base are the fan bases that are like gatekeepers, you know?
Like, oh wait, hold on. My villagers are breeding again, but
huge.
They don't give a shit. Okay. Like, anime fan base has a lot. Like, a lot of like fan base, like, you know, anime fan base, they're like, well, you can't, you're not an anime fan if you like only watch like popular shows. And I feel like they're retarded.
Just gatekeeping, basically.
Yeah. I feel like there are lots of like retarded fan bases. Oh no, I said retarded. I'm gonna get you demonetized.
Literally say retarded all the time, man. I don't know, man. I feel like just not saying retarded is just really retarded. I feel like it's not really... I don't know, man.
I don't think it's even, like, offensive.
Why is it offensive?
It shouldn't be offensive. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Like, if it's offensive, then people are retarded. Only retarded people think retarded is offensive. That makes sense.
No, not even retarded people think retarded is offensive.
No. Like, I mean, not retarded as in, like, you know, fucking neurodivergent. Retarded as in stupid.
As in stupid people, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Like... Like, I can get it with other words. Like, you know, like, how people say, oh, N-word is offensive. Because black people are called the N-word. That's why it's offensive. Or the F-word, because, like, usually gay people are called F-word. So I get why that is offensive. But, like, no one calls actual retarded people retarded, you know? So it's like, it doesn't make any sense it being offensive, you know?
Yeah. Like, I feel like people who get offended by the word retard, even though they're not like retarded themselves, I just think that they're like, I don't know, stupid. Like, it's mostly because, like, you know, a lot of like people that are not of like color.
Yeah.
I mean, like, you know, white people, right? It's usually white people.
Do you want to sleep?
You're not asleep. Yeah, I do.
Okay, give me a second.
Are you recording the Minecraft gameplay as well?
Yeah.
Okay, huge. So what happened to the what happened to the CSGO gameplay from yesterday? You're gonna use it in a video?
Fuck that.
No. That was actually like kind of good gameplay, the CSGO thing, because I was just like raging at you for no reason whatsoever. I was just like so like, oh shit.
Struggles. Oh, Bebe. What?
No.
There's a fucking zombie.
The zombies killed my villagers.
Oh shit. Damn, that sucks. That just the sucks. Zombies. Oh, there's a villager here. They got away somehow.
They survived.
Hello. He's so cute.
There's one survivor. Where's the other one?
I don't know.
I'm gonna need another villager.
How the fuck did they come out? How do I... Do you have a leash?
A leash?
Yeah.
Well, they're gonna go back either way. Like, he's gonna go back to... I think this guy's from another farm, maybe. Well, he's gonna go back eventually, like, to his job. So I just need, like, another villager.
Job plus income.
Anyway, like, don't really, like, get people or that are not of color who get offended by, like, things.
Yeah.
That people of color should get offended by. It's like, you know how I was telling you about, like, this, Like I mentioned to this guy, like, oh yeah, I said the N-word last year. And like the guy was like, and he's like, oh, you're racist, I'm not speaking to you, right?
Yeah.
And then apparently he just said that as a joke. But then like this girl who was white took it like extremely fucking seriously.
Oh.
And like I was like thinking about this last night, it made me feel like so fucking like shitty. Like not shitty as in like, you know, I'm racist, shitty as in like, I don't know, it just made me so fucking mad to just be like, you know, called racist.
Yeah.
Like when most of the people I talk to have never like experienced racism themselves. But I have, and I know what like actual racism is.
Yeah.
So, you know, I was thinking about it last night. Bro, no. This is such fucking slow gameplay. Look at wait, did you trap him?
Yeah.
Let him go to his job, bro.
What do you mean, guys? He was going to the fucking houses.
All right, let's just see what he does. Fuck it.
Oh,
he's gonna go to his job.
Dude has job plus income. What? He got into the boat.
Oh my god, bro!
What is this?
Oh. All right. Well, one of them is gonna go to his job.
What are we gonna do with this motherfucker? He's looking at me.
Squidward
looking at us.
Alright, we're gonna have to make a pathway for him. Alright.
Can I kill the Iron Golem? Or that's...
Nah. Right. I'd rather you didn't, because then you get like shit trade deals from villagers.
Oh, that's actually true. Alright, I'm gonna smelt some shit.
What are you doing? So like... So, like, then there was, like, this time when I was, like, explaining to the guy, like, the black person who, like, who got he said he got offended as a joke. I don't know how true that is. I don't know, because he, like, at the time, he was, like, taking it really seriously. Maybe he's just, like, you know, master troll or something.
Yeah.
We'll never know. Bro, these villagers are actually like fucking doing a good job. It's kind of huge. I just want to know where like the fucking other villager is.
The villager's looking at me, staring into my soul. Hello. He's so cute.
What, the Iron Golem or the villagers?
The villagers. I mean, they kind of look the same, their faces. Bro, this guy's running away. What do you do with him?
Alright, fuck it. Fuck it, I'm gonna trap him. Come here. Alright. He also... Alright, what I'm gonna do...
Alright, let me help you.
Since it... Nah, it's fine, I got this. What? Bro!
I'm helping you.
No, you're not! Look what you did!
What the fuck happened to him?
What do you think happened? Like, there's a fucking glitch with the water buckets.
Oh, there's a fucking glitch. Okay. I didn't know there was a glitch, alright? That's the fastest way to travel. Right, let me give him iron. Oh, I'm gonna heal the Iron Golem.
Okay.
There you go.
I get so fucking salty playing games even when it's Minecraft.
It's fucking Minecraft, bro. Calm down.
Alright. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break this composter and then place the composter again. So this villager now gets a job.
Job plus income. Huge.
Yeah, he should now get a job. And he did. Nice.
Very pog.
Very, very poggers. Okay.
Interesting.
Alright, so like, I was explaining to the guy, right? Like, why, like, I got like, you know, why, like, he really, like, should not have, like, said some stuff, like, to me.
Yeah.
And I was, like, explaining, like, you know, why, like, I'm not, like, racist, right? And I hate it when people like assume I'm racist for saying the N-word.
Yeah.
Especially since it was like fucking year ago when I said it to like a guy. I was like I said the N-word like, you know, in front of, like, he was also black. And I was telling, we were discussing, like, you know, when the N-word is inappropriate and inappropriate. And he pretty much told me, like, as long as it's within context, he doesn't give a shit. And so, like, I tested his theory. And like his definition of context turned out to be like you know, if you're singing it, it's fine, but like anything else, you're like, you know, it's not right. So that was his definition on context, right? Yeah. And I found that out by like saying the N-word in front of him, and he pretty much like got really fucking mad, because he thought I meant in a racist way, which like, you know, fair enough. It's a misunderstanding, but like that was like how long? Like I think that was a year or 2 years ago from now. Actually, no, it was still like a year ago or something.
Yeah.
And I was like talking to this other like black guy who got offended that I said the N-word a year ago. I don't know if this like continuity is making sense to anyone. So there are two black guys in the story. One of them I said the N-word like in front of a year ago, and the other one I told him that I said the N-word a year ago. So if hopefully that makes sense.
Yeah, I get what you're saying.
Yeah. So I was like discussing with the second black guy. I was discussing like the N-word with the second black guy, and I told him like I really fucking hate it when people call me a racist. And when I was like talking to him, I don't know why, but it really just felt like he just didn't give a shit about what I was saying.
Oh, okay.
Like it made it feel like it made it feel like my experience is like so fucking insignificant.
Yeah.
And I shouldn't like be complaining about some like stuff like that. Which, to be fair, like it probably isn't the case. Like, like saying it's insignificant is like massive, like disservice.
Yeah,
it's like, you know, like my experiences. He just kept saying like, you know, that how he personally doesn't like tend to like hold grudges. And I thought, like, you know, that's all what I was doing. It was like just I was just holding grudges, which, you know, isn't really the case.
Yeah.
I was actually like pretty, you know, like rightfully like mad at like the like people who have actually like been racist.
Yeah.
Okay, so this girl was I was like talking about like this girl, right? And I was just saying like I should not have said the N-word like a year ago. I mean, fair enough, but like I was explaining to her like, you know, why, like, you know, that isn't racist, like just saying a word like without any fucking context. Like it's like it means fucking nothing, you know. And I was sending her like I told her like, you know, she has no right to like call me a racist because she herself has not like experienced any like racism that like made her feel like in danger, like, you know, felt her life like, you know, in danger or something. And like and her response was like something like yeah, well, being called the N-word can make you feel your life is in danger. It's such a fucking like free response. I mean, like, I don't know, bro. I said the N-word like pretty much like throughout my entire life just because I thought it was funny. But I wasn't like up until like last year when I was like, wait, hold on, maybe like saying the N-word is like, you know, it might be like, you know, a trigger word for some people. So yeah, I should like, you know,
that's true.
Watch when I say it. But like you know, with trigger words, right, how I usually go is just don't say the word in front of the people that it triggers, right? So if you know like a certain word triggers a certain someone, don't say it. Like that's kind of how I operate.
Yeah.
With the N-word, however, like I just don't say it at all because people don't treat it as a trigger word. People mostly treat it as like, you say it, you're racist. So like, if I don't want to be racist, right? So I just don't say it. Like I don't, I like, you know, I like it can like fucking ruin like my future, like job. Like it could have effects on like my future career.
And I don't understand that either. Like how you can just, I don't know, just the whole cancel culture thing is the most stupid thing that happened. It all came from Twitter. That's all I believe is that, like, it all came from Twitter. It's just the most stupid thing ever. Like, you made one mistake, you said something bad once, and now it's just over for you. You're just the worst person ever.
Cancel culture, bro. It all, like, do you know where, like, cancel culture even came from? Like,
I don't know, man.
How it started?
Bro, I just know it came from Twitter. Because in Twitter, you know, the whole social media is about talking. Like, you know, Instagram is about taking pictures and just sharing pictures, all right? And Facebook is about, like, posting stuff or just, like, it's more formal. Twitter is just about opinions. And so many people in life have so many shitty opinions. So many people have just shit opinions, right? And Twitter is just a place for them to just share their shitty stuff and find people like themselves, right? So all these people with shitty opinions just find people like themselves and they make an army and they force people to, like, you know, have a hive mind and basically, like, witch hunt other people and be like, oh, this person said something and now everybody has their opinion on them and now they're just cancelled.
Maddie.
What?
Did you give one of them wheat?
What? No, I didn't.
Okay.
There were six. Maybe they just picked it up.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, it's not working still, bro. Why? Alright, wait, hold on. Hold on, let me try and fix it again.
Remember yesterday we were talking about, like, Call Me Carson and the whole thing happened to him? Like, he basically got cancelled, but I just don't understand it, man. It's just how people call him a monster and they just compare him to, like, actual child predators, you know? Like, I just don't understand. See, like, that's the thing with cancel culture, though. Like, it doesn't matter what you did. Just, they call you a rapist and it doesn't matter. Like, there's no difference, you know? There's no difference between Call Me Carson and fucking, like, Kevin Spacey. Because you know what Kevin Spacey did, right? Like, he actually...
Pretty sure, like, he, like, sexually harassed a bunch of women, right?
No, children. Children? Yeah. Boy, like, little boys, basically. Was his child predator. Like, you know...
Like, the guy from House of Cards.
Yeah.
I thought it was women, not children.
No,
bro.
It was a children. So, see, like, with cancel culture, they're like, oh, they're both the same thing. They're both predators. While there's, like, a huge difference between that and, like, Call Me Carson, you know?
Yeah. Alright, come to my house.
Oh. You're inviting me to your house? Hello? Bro?
Hello?
You can now rest. Dude, I think... your dog hates me, man.
It's alright. He's just like, he'll hate you once I, like, fucking attack you.
You were. Alright.
Alright, you know, I'm gonna like try and add a door, see if that makes a difference. Right.
I'm committing mass murder.
Committing genocide.
Right. I'm gonna kill your parents. Right.
Bro, what the fuck?
I'm killing sheep.
Right. Let's see if adding a door helps.
Let's see, Adam.
Who is Adam? And why...
Who is Adam?
Colin Carson just got cancelled for fucking nothing. Like, I didn't even, like, enjoy watching his shit. Like,
nah, I didn't enjoy him a lot. Like, his humor is exactly my humor. Like, the most,
bro,
like...
His humor is so shit.
Yeah,
bro.
I know, but I love it. It's, like, just awkward, so cringe humor.
I think there's only, like, one video where, like, I actually enjoyed. And that was, like, a BuzzFeed quiz.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
You know that one?
Yeah.
It's like food, like the one with food and shit. And that's like the that was like the only one that I liked. The other one I thought was so fucking like trash.
Yeah, there's something about like really lame cringe humor that I fucking love. It's just awkward humor, you know?
Yeah. Know what's shit now? That
What?
my farm, it has fucking wheat in it.
Pain.
This is actually pain.
And they're not even fucking. Why don't have children?
All right, we'll see. It's not mating time yet. The mating time is during the mornings and during the afternoons.
For a moment. Right.
You know who should have been like fucking not even canceled, like arrested and put to jail?
Parsonical, is it?
Tyrus Nichol,
Is
yeah.
it?
Tyrus Nichol, bro. Like Tyrus Nichol, like people are like, oh, Tyrus Nichol survived the cancel culture. Bro, he's a
Dude.
criminal. The guy's a criminal. Like a lot of people will like disagree because like I was like following the situation from like the very start, you know?
Yeah.
Like I was like as soon as I heard like, you know, cause, like as soon as I heard anything about like parsonical, like I just like followed the situation in like a lot of detail, right? Because I really like parsonical, you know. Cause he was like my favorite YouTuber, right? So I was like, nah, this can't be. And then I actually like looked into it myself. So much so that I actually like spoke to the victim and stuff.
Yeah.
Like he told me a lot of fucking stuff that like no like he wouldn't have been able to told me if like you know if he didn't know what he was talking about. Stuff like Parsnickel's fucking friends and how like who he interacted with and like I don't know, like just like a lot of stuff that like, you know, a fan, like just a fan would not be able to tell me.
Yeah.
You know. So like looking into all that, like it's so fucking obvious like Parsnickel knew the age, like knew how old Ivory was. And like he continued to lie even in his videos, and he should have like been fucking jailed. Right,
Yeah.
like the guys are fucking like we used to use this word law as a fucking joke, but the guy's actually a menace. He's actually a menace to
Actual
society.
menace of society.
Yeah, like Parasitical is unironically and like a menace to society, and I have no doubt that he's gonna continue like doing this shit. Like I've no doubt Parasitical's gonna continue to like you know. Like he like the one thing I got from Parsnickel is that he just doesn't give a shit how old you are. Just doesn't give a shit. Like as long as you can like keep him entertained, he's fine. We're just Adam, bro.
Exactly like Adam. All right, very
I
nice.
think Adam would be proud.
Adam would be proud of what?
I don't know, of being just Adam.
I feel like Adam wakes up every morning just looking himself in the mirror like, bro, I'm Adam. Holy shit.
People don't even know who Adam is.
Yeah. The funny thing is Adam doesn't even know who Adam is. He himself doesn't know. He's a fucking hero to us, man.
Yeah.
I feel like
Bro,
I really want to
Adam.
just in the future one day meet Adam and tell him, bro,
You saved us.
you
You're
saved
a
our
national
whole
treasure.
comedy, yeah. Your whole inside joke is to us.
We owe you our lives,
Owe
Adam.
you our
You're
lives.
just, yeah, you're just Adam.
Funny thing is, I have his Instagram too, and I was looking at his Instagram yesterday. I was like, bro, it's just Adam.
Wait, did you ever tell Adam then?
No, I don't know what to say to him. How should they approach this subject that you're literally the inside joke of a whole community?
Just be like, hey, you're just Adam.
You're just Adam.
Yeah.
Alright. Yeah, it's kind of funny. Adam. It's kind of funny the fact that, like, you know, like, he doesn't know, right? And just think that, like, have you done something that, like, someone remembers for the rest of your life and they don't even know you and they make jokes about it
for the rest of your life? I don't even think I've ever, like, spoke to Adam.
No, I'm not talking about Adam. Just forgot Adam. Forget Adam for a second. I'm talking about, like, you.
Forget Adam. How can I?
Can we forget Adam? Fucking Adam.
You're asking me to do the impossible. Forget Adam. Ask me.
Should we explain the Adam joke, but like very vaguely, so people actually know Adam?
I don't know how we can, to be honest.
I mean, we can kind of. So there is this person that we both know. His name is Adam.
Well, to be fair, we don't really know.
We don't really know him.
At least I don't. Like, I never spoke to the guy. I just saw him around. I just saw him around.
I never spoke to the guy either. But we just know him. We just know who he is. And he done something kind of fucked up. But, you know, it's okay. It's the past. But for some reason, we just use him as an example to say he's a menace to society. And we just...
Okay, you know, let's explain, like, what he actually did.
Because that would be too obvious. What if his friends actually, like, watch this video one day and...
Oh, who gives a shit?
I give a shit. Bro, he's really buff. I don't want him to beat me up.
Bro, what's he gonna do? He's gonna come to Iran and beat you up? But fuck no.
Bro, I'll be in UK in 2 months. He's gonna fucking...
What's he gonna do? He's gonna track you down?
I know, man.
Right. He's like, you better, we've mentioned his name so many fucking times.
Right,
like,
okay.
His friends are all obviously no.
Do you want me to tell the whole story?
How would, like, I explain, like, from my side, and then you explain, like, like, the actual thing. So, like, during COVID, like, a bunch of people couldn't go home, right?
Yeah.
So, hold on.
Bless you, my child. You will be blessed.
Thank you. Yeah, so, like, a bunch of people couldn't go home. And my villagers still can't fucking breed. Bro, what is this? Okay. So, during quarantine, a bunch of people couldn't go home. Because, like, I don't fucking know why. Why couldn't they go home?
Because... I guess we were just stuck in the college because... I don't know, man. It was, like, the beginning of COVID. That's why. Because, like, it kind of peaked in Brighton. So, they were like, bro, just stay. You can't. You either had to, like... get out of the college and never come back, basically. Or just stay in the college. So, most people choose to, like, stay in college because, you know, there were still, like, exams and stuff.
Okay. So, I guess, like, yeah. A lot of people didn't, like, go home. In that regard. So, like, a few people were just, like, done. Like, few people were, like, I guess there were, like, three, like, modules, I guess, right? Well, yeah. Not really module, like courses.
Yeah.
GCSE, A-level, and foundation. And I guess, like, some people are just done with their courses, right? One of them was, like, Adam. Just Adam. Yeah. Anyway, so, like, hold on, Maddie, let's go to sleep.
All right.
So what I thought happened was, like, at the same time, like, the company that our college is under, like, they kind of had to do some budget cuts. So, like, two of the colleges, like, merged together, right?
Yeah.
So there used to be, like, two colleges, but, like, since, like, because of budget cuts, they, like, merged both of those colleges into one. So what I thought happened was, like, a bunch of people from the other college, right? Since they were, like, fairly new, and they were also, like, foreign. They didn't really... I felt like, since they didn't really understand, like, you know, like, a bunch of stuff, I just thought, like, they just went into, like, the art department, which is, like, you know, Yeah, we have, like, I'm pretty sure most schools have, like, an art department.
Yeah.
But, like, so I thought, like, a bunch of people just went into the art department and just, you know, like, made a mess of everyone's work. Mm. Keep in mind, there are, like, a bunch of people who weren't finished with their, like, exams, and one of them just so happened to be, like, doing A-levels.
Yeah.
Which is, like, the hardest course in our college, right?
Yeah.
Like, that was, and this person was doing A-level art. And what I heard was, like, a bunch of people from, like, the other college, they, like, ruined and, like, spilt paint and, like, all over, like...
the art projects, like, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much, like, the people's art project on purpose, right?
Mm.
And, that's what I heard.
Yeah.
Apparently, there was more to it. Apparently, it wasn't a bunch of people.
It was just Adam.
It was just Adam.
So, basically, what happened was that I heard this, because I was in the college at that time, and this was, like, a huge thing. This was a big thing. And one of the people that this happened, it was actually, like, just a few people. It was, like, I heard a story that they focused on one person's work, and that was, like, one of my friends. And then I was, like, talking to her and being like, bro, like, what happened? And she was, like, really sad because it was, like, before she could present her work to the university, but she couldn't anymore. Yeah. So there was a risk of her not getting to university because her work was ruined. And she was, like, really depressed. I basically talked to her, and I was like,
wait, yeah. Is she in university now?
Yeah, because... she's going to university. Like, the university was so nice. They were like, bro, it's okay. Like, we understand what happened and it's all right. So I talked to her and I asked her, like, oh, like, what happened and stuff like that. I heard, like, so many people, like, came to... this was her response. No, it was just Adam. Adam came, ruined my artwork and made fun of me. So it wasn't much of people. It was just Adam, a menace to society.
Yeah, and like I was like discussing this with Maddie like a few days ago. I was like, bro, didn't like a bunch of like people from the other college just like ruin this girl's artwork? And I was like, no, it was just Adam.
It was just Adam, bro. It's just Adam, bro. No one else.
Bro, Adam would fucking get out of fucking disabled person in a wheelchair. just for being in the bike lane while he's riding a bike.
nice.
Adam would be riding in the wrong lane of like the bike, and then yell at a person in the wheelchair for being in the bike lane. I'd say, nice bike, dumbass.
It's your menace, damn.
Adam is a fucking true man. I don't know if he's a fucking menace or a hero. Obviously he's not a hero because
Adam,
like he fucked up like Chantas.
Adam, you're not gonna, you probably, I don't know if he's gonna hear this, you fucked up, mate, but you're really funny, like, your story is really funny, so.
It's just Adam. I never fucking spoke to the guy, like, I saw him, like, a couple of times.
I never spoke to him either, I don't even know what he does.
Like, I saw him a couple of times, like, in the train station, heading back from gym or something. Like, I never fucking spoke to him. Like, it's, like, I don't know, he was so much of a fucking menace, and I didn't even know it until I left.
Fucking Adam, bro. Oh my fucking god, Twitter. I feel like this is a good place to end it. We went from Minecraft to racism to sexism to Adam. Good story.
Did you talk about sexism?
Not really.
We didn't really talk about
that'll
sexism.
Be good
we
for
just
talked
about
next
fucking
episode.
Call Me Carson.
Oh, yeah,
we just talked about Call Me Carson, pyrocynical.
Huge. Alright.
Pyrocynical, who's more of a menace? Dude, pyrocynical or Adam?
I feel like Adam is.
Pyrocynical harasses children online, but like fucking Adam.
No,
though.
Bro, Adam.
Adam ruins art projects.
Alright.
Pyrocynical destroys lives while Adam destroys careers.
This is actually really good. Alright. This was very nice. Thanks for watching if you're still watching.
You'll hear me rage in another fucking Valorant or CSGO video.
Yes.
Even a fucking Minecraft video if Maddie decides to make one.
Yeah, bro. One day. Pog, pog, bye-bye.